Today is Tartan Day. We're off to the North Carolina Museum of History to go learn about our Scottish-Irish, or Scots-Irish, ancestral roots. We're going to see a lot of kilts and maybe even some highland dancing.
Swords or slicing swords?
This is a, it's not sharp.
It is meant to break bones, so it's meant to be used as a basic.
Okay, so not a run you through, but more of a like.
Run you through. Now, your enemy is wearing armor, so something sharp is not going to do anything to armor. It's going to cut off. The worst it's going to do is stick in. You don't want your sword getting stuck because when you get
that. Yeah, that's true.
So you would hit elbows, knees, collarbones.
Makes sense. Makes perfect sense. So I saw somebody holding a bagpipe, and I hope you guys are going to give a performance.
Yes, ma'am. We're going to play 12.
12. Okay. Is it going to be, I'm assuming outside since bagpipes are loud, or is it going to be inside? Inside.
We played earlier. We played up on the balcony.
Oh, I missed it. Oh, I'm so excited. Thank you.
All right.
They are. Observation skills winning! Auditorium schedule, there we go. Scottish genealogy. Okay, we're gonna go sit all the way in the middle. I'll tell you when to stop. Yep, this can be your seat, right here. See a bunch of thistles up there, I think. I hope.
Right. All right. welcome everybody to Tartan Day 2017. We're getting ready to display some Scottish dancing. We have dancers from the Annandale Center and the Raleigh Scottish Dance Center. Both of them are up. We have a table at the end of the hall with some pamphlets on both schools. So come check us out after you see the dancing. All right, so we're going to start off with the half tullet. So this is a reel of tullet. It started in Tullet Churchyard in a cold winter morning when the minister was late for his service. The parishioners tried to keep warm by stamping their feet and clapping their hands and swinging each other by the arms. This dance is performed by four dancers together and is judged individually in each competition. So we'll go ahead and let them. Decided to enter a highland dance competition. This was not expressly forbidden, she was allowed to enter, since the number of females participating in the sport has increased. Today, in excess of 95% of all dancers are female. So our next dance is going to be called the Blue Bonnets. So Blue Bonnets over border, abbreviated to Blue Bonnets. It's a ladies' dance that's done to farewell to the Scottish soldiers. These soldiers were nicknamed Blue Bonnets because of the traditional hats that they wore, called tams. That soldiers wore. The tams were blue because there was a limited dye colors available and blue is abundant. So when making hats for hundreds of soldiers, that's used with what's around. Sir Walter Scott wrote the lyrics to accompany the traditional song this dance is performed to. The name of this next dance, it refers to old trousers. It's believed that the dance was developed in 1740. 1645, during the Jacobite Rising, when Flying Prince Charlie came to Scotland from France to win back the crown. Initially, the uprising was a success, and the Jacobite army rapidly broke out into the Highlands and captured Edinburgh, and advanced far south to Derby, England. Unfortunately, the army lacked the necessary French support, so they retreated back to the strongholds of the Highlands, where it was finally defeated at the Culloden Moor near Inverness in 1746. Afterwards, the government decided once and for all to end the Jacobite military threat, and the Jacobites were rounded up and imprisoned. Their lands and estates were taken, and the clan system dismantled, and their kilts and plaids were outlawed during the Act of Proscription. Some suggest that the chantreuse was created as an act when this act was repealed in 1783, and the Highlanders were once again allowed to wear their kilts. The first part of the dance is balletic in brushing movements, but thought by some to mimic the clansman shedding his hated trews or trousers. The quick steps through are reflected the Highlanders returning to his tradition of Highland dress, and custom as quick steps are similar in style to the Highland fling. Traditional Scottish country style dance. You'll see a lot of elements that relate to the clogging that you're familiar with and tapping, so we'll show you that here. Thank you. ankles hurt after just watching them.
Yeah, that was fun.
All right, so the next dance we're going to have is the Flora McDonald's Fancy. This dance is choreographed in honor of the famed Flora McDonald. After the massacre at Culloden in 1746, Bonnie Prince Charlie had a high price on his head, and Flora helped him escape the Isle of Skye, and disguising her as his maid, Betty Burke. The crossing was short but dangerous, and the small boat weathered both bullets from the shore and storms. Both survived, and the prince escaped to France. Flora was later arrested when her part in the escape became known. However, her courage and ingenuity and popular appeal meant that she was well-treated and later released from the Tower. She and her family actually then moved here to North Carolina and helped the Loyalists in the Revolutionary War. Scotland's in battle past. Some suggestions that Malcolm Canmore, King of Scotland, who ruled this country from 1054 to 1096, created the dance. In 1054, the Malcolm Canmore began the military campaign Macbeth made famous. Malcolm, supported by the Earl of Northumberland, was able to force territorial concession from Macbeth at the Battle of Dunsmane, July 24, 1054. It's also said that warriors danced the Scottish dance prior to battle. If the warrior touched their swords, it was considered a bad omen for battle. Today, penalties for touching swords are much less severe, and in competition, points are deducted from a dancer's score if they touch the swords. Another little advertisement while they're getting finished set up. We're having a Cayley April 22nd in Cary at the Art Center. It's an evening of Scottish and Irish dance, culture, poetry, you name it, and it's a great time. So if you have the opportunity, come down to the Cary Art Center and check it out with us.